The previous video introduced you to kind of what theories were in general, but this one we're going to talk about some of the different types of theories. Specifically, we're going to look at conceptual models and what the four metaparadigm of nursing are. So please don't get bogged down by what all these words mean. Metaparadigm, that's a huge word, but it really is simple. So we're going to talk about that right now. Basically, a conceptual model of nursing was the early nursing researchers' ways to try to explain what nursing practice is. At the beginning of our discipline, when we were trying to be known as a profession, we had to establish our own science and our own language and kind of separate ourselves from other healthcare disciplines like medicine, physical therapy, dietitians, and nutritionists. So we had to be able to say specifically, what is nursing? What are we trying to do as nurses that is different from other types of healthcare disciplines? And so basically, the conceptual models, that's why they were created to say, this is nursing. This is what we're doing every day in our practice when we're working with patients. Some people call them grand theories. What basically, they're very abstract. They're super, super big picture. Like, this is what nurses do. It's not specifically talking about a labor and delivery nurse or a cardiac rehab nurse. It's talking about all nurses. So it's super abstract and very out there. But all of the grand theories or conceptual models were basically built around four concepts. Remember, concepts are the building blocks of theories. You take all these concepts, talk about how they relate to one another, and then you've got a theory that explains what nursing is. So the meta paradigms are those four core concepts are human beings, environment, health, and nursing. So all of those original theorists in the 50s and 60s who were trying to tell people this is what nurses do, they describe nursing using those four words: nurses, health, environment, and people, human beings. Now, obviously, if every single one of us in this class went around and told what we thought those four words mean, we would all have something different. You know, we'd probably have some overlap. We might use words like caring and internal and external environment and stress or whatever, but they're all going to be different. No one person views nursing in exactly the same way. The theorists do not all view nursing in exactly the same way. And I think that's what's cool about it because you can kind of find which theorist speaks your language. You know, I've over the years of looking and using these theories have found some that are my favorites. Because I kind of get where the researcher or the theorist is coming from. He or she is speaking my same language. So I hope that you kind of find some of these and you're like, oh, that sounds like how I practice nursing every day, because that's probably your spirit theorist, if you will. So nursing into those early researchers or theorists was how nurses interact with people within the environment with the ultimate outcome of promoting or extending health. Okay, and how they define those words was different, obviously. Now, I think it's really neat, and I wanted to share this with you because you may not have known this, but once upon a time, the College of Nursing and Health Professions had its own little framework. This was kind of our grand theory or conceptual framework that defined what we thought nursing was, because we needed to understand what nursing was if we're going to teach nursing to students. Kind of makes sense. So we viewed nurses as being important in the environment as we interact with the person within the environment, and this is nursing. And nursing was built around roles, service, professionalism, critical thinking, therapeutic nursing interventions, and there's different types and levels of nursing. Our framework has changed a bit, but this was frankly the picture I could find, so here it is. But a lot of these models, these theories and models can be pictured using graphics like the one you see on the slide. Sometimes these graphics or these models, schematics, make it a little bit more easy to see where people were coming from. So, a lot of the conceptual models that have been used, you may have even heard about some of these, but one of the most common is called Roy's adaptation model, Sister Calista Roy. She was one of the early theorists who tried to explain how nurses work with patients within the environment to help promote adaptation. That's how she viewed health, is adaptation. Some of the other models that you may have heard of, or you may not have, would be, let's see, Orem's self-care deficit nursing theory. When I worked in home health, I really used Orem's theory a lot because I felt that that's the whole purpose of home health was to try to help people fill in the deficits of their self-care so that they could become independent as much as possible based on their condition and where they were physically and mentally and developmentally. Some of the other ones, healthcare systems model, you probably think in ways of systems. Some of these, I'm not gonna lie, are way out there. Some of these are super, super abstract. When you start getting into Parse and Rogers and this Newman, some of these are a little bit difficult to understand because they use really abstract concepts. This is an example of the pictorial representation of Roy's adaptation model. This does not make a lick of sense to you. My whole purpose of this video is not to have you be an expert at Roy's adaptation model. What I'm trying to show you is that within this model, there is the nurse, the person, environment, and health. All of that's going on in here. She may not have labeled that, but every one of these grand theories or conceptual models had those four meta paradigm in them. So Roy looked at health as coping, adapting to the environment. Okay, so we've got the environment going on here, and then our health is how well or how well we do or do not adapt to the changes and stresses that we encounter. And nurse's whole purpose, according to Roy, was to help clients build their processes for coping. Okay, so it might be physical pain, it might be psychological, it might be in their way that they're interdependent in their roles, but whatever it is, we got to help them adapt. We've got to give them the process to help them cope. So that's just one example. I'm not going to get too far into this, but this is very abstract. So note that all of these conceptual models or grand theories are great. They help us understand a little bit about nursing, but they're so abstract that it's difficult to use them to explain our nursing practice. You know, as an oncology nurse, I could kind of see my practice in this. You know, newly diagnosed or new complications or coming out of remission. So you can see that, but it's very difficult to take this big model and do research on it. So while grand theories are helpful, they're not really useful for informing research. But the next video that you're going to watch is about middle range theories, and those are super accessible and helpful for performing research. And many of them came from these grand theories.